Guys, I got another question for you. What are the different types of joins in SQL? All right, now there are four types of joins when it comes to working with databases. There's an inner join, an outer join, a left join, and a right join. So let's start off with the inner join. An inner join is when you return records that have at least one match between two or more tables. As you can see below, we have two tables, one table called customer and another one called ticket. The customer table has four columns: customer ID, customer name, phone number, email, whereas the ticket consists of a ticket ID, customer ID, the part location, as well as the destination location. Now, these tables are set up in order to keep track of the customers that are associated with each ticket, or keep track of the tickets associated with each customer. So this is how they work. So when you're working with inner joins, let's say you wanted to join these two tables. At the top, you can see here, this is the query that you would write in order to join these two tables. You would write select customer ID, customer name, department, the part location, destination location from the customer table, and you want to join that customer table with the ticket table, and the only way that these tables are joining is by the common row that they have between these two tables, which is customer ID. So when you're working with an inner join, that's when you return records that have at least one match between two or more tables. So as you can see here in the customer table, we have the first customer, Susan Morley, who has a customer ID of 1. She also has a customer ID in this ticket table, which holds a foreign key to the customer ID of this customer table, of the primary key of the customer table. So when we perform a join, we're returning records that have at least one match between two tables. So we have 1 and 1, which match. So we're going to get Susan Morley. She's going from Maine to Georgia. And then we also have a customer ID here, number 2, which also matches with a record in this ticket table. So we're going to get Jack Panner. And Jack Panner is going from California to North Carolina. Number 3 here, Stephen Jacobs. This is also present within this ticket table, so he will also be returned down here. And 4 is also a match, as we can see here, between the ticket and the customer table. So we're going to get Miranda Wright, who's going from Georgia to Utah. Now, if you notice, we have an extra record here in the ticket table who has a customer ID of 20. Now, this record right here is not going to be returned because there is no match. So for example, if there was another record here, like number 5, and it wasn't present in this table, then we won't return that record because the inner join only returns records that have at least one match between two or more tables. Now, an outer join is when you return all records between two or more tables. So we have here also is the customer table as well as the ticket table. Now, this is the query that you would write in order to perform an outer join. It's pretty much going to look like the query in the previous slide, but the only thing that's changing here is going to be this outer join that we have here. So we have our two tables, our customer table and a ticket table. And when we join these tables, it's going to return all records between two or more tables. So we're going to have this table, which is constructed here. Okay, we're going to have the customer ID, customer name, department location, and the depart location and the destination name. And as you can see here, all records are going to be returned within this table. So the first thing that we're going to grab is the record for Susan Morley. She has a customer ID of 1 here, as well as a customer of ID 1 in the ticket table. And she also has another customer ID of 1 in this ticket table. So there's going to be two records that are returned for Susan Morley. Then the same thing goes for Jack Panner. His customer ID number is 2, and we also have a 2 here. So this record, as well as this record, is going to be returned. So we're going to get Jack Panner. We're going to get the customer ID, and then customer name is Jack Panner. And then from this table, we're actually going to grab the depart location as well as the destination location, which are Maine and Georgia. All right, and the same goes for number three. Now, when we get to number four, what's happening is that Miranda Wright, who has a customer ID of 4, does not have a customer of ID 4 in this table as a foreign key. So the only thing that we're going to get from Miranda Wright is the first part of this record. Because as I said before, when you're doing an outer join, that's when you return all records between two or more tables. So even if there's not a reference for this Miranda Wright in the ticket table, then it's still going to return a record. It's just that the values for the depart location and the destination location is going to be equal to null. Next, I want to talk about a left join. A left join is when you return all records from the left table with matching records in the right table. So none matching records in the right table will be null. All right, so this is the query that we're going to run, which is going to perform a left join in which you return all records in the left table with matching records in the right table. So as far as all records, we're going to return records 1, 2, 3, and 4. As you can see here, 1, 2, and 3, and 4, all these records are going to be returned with matching records in the right table. So we're going to have each one of these records. We have Susan Morley, who has been added 3 times. So Susan Morley right here has a customer ID of 1. And we have 3 customer IDs of 1 in this particular table. So Susan Morley is going to be returned 3 times. So 1, 2, and 3. And she has apparently purchased 3 tickets to different locations. And we go to the second one, Jack Panner. He's going from Texas to Washington, as well as Alabama to Idaho. So all these records are going to have information in it. But when we get to these null values, we're not going to get any value back. And the reason we're not getting any value back is because if you look at this, customer ID 3, Stephen Jacobs, is not present in this ticket table. So if it's not present in this ticket table, then we're going to get ourselves a null value here. Because as I said before, the left join returns all records from the left table. So no matter what, all these records are going to be returned, 1, 2, and 3, and 4. And since we're also looking up this department location and department and destination location, then if there's no destination location or depart location, then we're just going to simply return null. And the reason we return null, as I said before, I keep repeating it, is because there is no match between these two records, Stephen Jacobs and Miranda Wright. Stephen Jacobs and Miranda Wright, customer ID 3 and 4, is not present in this table, so that's why we're getting that null. And next, I want to talk about the right join. It's pretty much the same as the left join. It just states that when you return all, you're going to be returning records in the right table with matching records in the left table. So none matching records in the left table are going to be null. All right, so this is the query that we would write. We still have our same tables, and we're basically saying we're going to return all records in the right table. So 4, 4, 1, 3. We're going to return all these records in the right table with matching records in the left table. All right. So we're going to return each one of these records. So 4 is going to match with this left table of customer. So Miranda Wright is going to be here. And then we have another 4 here, which is also going to be returned, because remember, as I said before, all records in the right table that have right join is when we return all records in the right table with matching records in the left table. So we're going to have 4, 4. We're also going to have 1 and 3 that are going to be returned. If you notice, we're not going to have 2 within this table, because that record does not match with any record in the right table here. So that's not going to be returned in the result. So I think this is pretty straightforward. If you have any questions, just let me know. Now, if you have any, we've reached the end of the video. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments below. Don't forget to like the video if you've learned something here. Also, don't forget to subscribe, and see you in the next one.